I just angle it that way, there's room for my butt.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Music at Noon. How are you on this hot summer afternoon? All right. Are you Capital Public Radio listeners? Yeah. That's a reason for being here. And Jennifer has friends. So when you get Jennifer, you get other people too. Thank you very much, Jennifer. So today it's Jennifer Reason and Friends, and if you're not aware, if you're listening from Africa or Germany, Jennifer Reason happens to be our morning radio announcer for classical music here in Sacramento, California. Today's date, of course, is, hey, I've seen you before, welcome back. Today's date is May 25th, 2022. It's our 902nd concert. Where have you been? Let's see, Jennifer has been here for about 890 of them. Is that true? Not quite. Well, she's been in your life for a lot of concerts, hasn't she? I call her the mellifluous voice of music here in Sacramento. She just has a style all her own, doesn't she? And you really learn a lot from her too, don't you? Because she's got the inside perspective as a musician announcer of classical music. So when Jennifer speaks, I listen. So she's starting off the program today, but her friends are going to join her. So I call this a very eclectic program today. And you can almost see that just by looking at the program. There is something on today's concert for everyone, from old music to new music. Maybe not that old, the music. And she's also honoring Sondheim in his recent passing, which is a wonderful thing. And we have contemporary composers who are still writing music today. So who else will you hear? You will hear a friend of Jennifer's. Her name is Anne Moss. She's a soprano. She has sung here more than 10 years ago, and she stayed in Sacramento area just to sing for you today because she has to go back to Massachusetts. So she's here for you today to sing some wonderful music. Music today that goes everything from meditative to powerful, wide range. And then we get to hear Kathy Apple, flutist. We haven't heard her as much as we normally do because of COVID. So it's wonderful to have her back. And then she will also join in the piano trio at the end of today's concert, which will be Kathy Apple Flute. She should be Kathy Flute anyway. Kathy Apple Flute. Timothy Stanley is cello. I'm sorry I didn't mention his name. Timothy Stanley. And Jennifer Reason on piano. So let's welcome our first guest, Jennifer Reason.
Thank you so much. It's amazing to see you all out here. Familiar faces, unfamiliar faces, we're back, we did it. I haven't played on Music at Noon since before COVID, and I'm just full of joy that this concert series has lived. So Brad, thank you for keeping this going. Well, as Brad mentioned, this concert has it all. I'm going to go ahead and take you on a journey of 1,000 years of music in 1 hour. So buckle up, it's going to be a ride, it's going to be joyful, it's going to be a celebration of being together, of championing artists and women in particular who may not have gotten the spotlight for hundreds of years, but damn it, they get it today. So, all that being said, we will have the party, we will have the celebration together, but we would be remiss to not start off with acknowledgement of the world today. Yes, we have Ukraine, and it's many months at this point. We have the unspeakable tragedy that happened yesterday. So my first two selections today will speak to that. I'll go ahead and play them as a set. Mary Kamugian is an Armenian immigrant, and almost her entire family, mostly women, were obliterated in the Armenian genocide. Those that managed to get out, which were literally like a niece, the one grandma maybe, they managed to get here. So I'm gonna play you the lullaby that she wrote once they found safety and peace, but you will hear in that the bittersweet nature of the fact that it's only a remnant that get that peace. The Fantasia is from a wonderful Japanese anime, if we have Studio Ghibli fans. It's Nausicaa of the Valley of the Wind. And in this tale, there's been a catastrophic conflict. It's obliterated most of humanity. There's little pockets that have made it, but Nausicaa notices that it's nature that lives on and is attempting to use what is there, the wind, the insects, to restore peace to a ravaged planet.
Thank you.
thank you. Well, now, it is my absolute pleasure to welcome the very first of my friends and a very dear one here from Massachusetts. For you, how fantastic is that? Anne Moss is going to take us from the earliest music ever written, but we'll start with Joni Mitchell.
And when I ask you why, you raise your sticks and cry, and I fall. Oh, my friend, how did you come to trade the fiddle for the drum? And so I ask you, please, can I help you find the peace and the star? Oh, my friend, what time is this to trade the handshake for the fist? And so
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. So a group of composers and songwriters here who are very much among us. Composers, they walk among us still. They're all around us. They're our teachers. They're our friends. And one incredible composer-songwriter who we lost quite recently, Stephen Sondheim. We wanted to share a song of his from a musical called Evening Primrose. This is not so well known. It was a musical written for television. And it centers around a short story written about a poet who has taken refuge from the world and hidden inside of a department store. And he finds there a group, a secret group of people who are also hidden in this department store. And he falls in love with a young woman named Ella. And it turns out that Ella has been in this department store since she was a very young girl. She fell asleep in the women's hat department and came separated from her mother. And when she woke up, this group of secret department store dwellers took her in. So Charles, the poet, falls in love with Ella and learns more of her story and realizes she hasn't seen the sun for almost 16 years. And he says, "Oh, you haven't seen the sun." And she says, "Yes, but I remember."
I remember sky. Still I answer you.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Well, it was my absolute pleasure to thank Anne Moss again. Thank you, Anne. And also to welcome the next resident badass, Dr. Kathy Applefriends. I'm not going to tell you much about this piece because it's an experience. But here's your hint. It's Irish flute iteration meets gospel meets juicy groove. And because this is an eclectic performance, that's what we're going to do. When I first heard that, I was like, Irish flute meets gospel? So I guess you can decide if it works. I think it works.
Thank you.
Well, we near the end of the program. I wanted to say just the hugest of thanks to you. That was the wettest ink, if you will, the newest piece, clearly. So, of course, now we need to go to the oldest piece. And it was my absolute delight to discover that there is still music around that we can see and touch and feel, manuscripts that have survived 1,000 years. It's incredible. Hildegard von Bingen, born 1098, if you can believe that. And here we are in 2022, about to perform her music, but in a much more modern way, but also not. It's very drone, it's very experimental almost. And it's just, I love that it's a woman that has the title of oldest written music. We're gonna go from there to the fireworks and the grand finale finish of the Beethoven era, but it's not Beethoven, it's also a woman. So please enjoy 4 very brief chants from Hildegard, and then we'll wrap up with some Louise Farrakh.
trees are turning their own bodies into pillars of light, are giving off the rich fragrance of cinnamon and fulfillment. The long tapers of cattails are bursting and floating away over the blue shoulders of the ponds, and every pond, no matter what its name is nameless now. Every year, everything I have ever learned in my lifetime leads back to this. The fires and the black river of loss, whose other side is salvation, whose meaning none of us will ever know. To live in this world, you must be able to do three things: to love what is mortal, to hold it against your bones, knowing your own life depends on it, and when the time comes, to let it go, to let it go.
Thank you so much. A huge thanks to Kathy Apple, to Ann Moss, to Tim Stanley, to Brad Slocum. Dear Brad, thank you for having us. While we set up in tune, I'll just tell you a little about Louise Ferranc. We're only going to play the first chunk of her piano trio. And chunk, movement, chunk. Louise Ferranc, born 1804, she was the only woman in the entire 19th century that managed to persuade the powers that be that she deserved to teach at the Paris Conservatory, which was the place to study. The only woman, if you can imagine that. They paid her just a pittance in comparison. She also then turned into the first woman to champion equal pay, because she said, hey, wait a minute, I'm teaching here out in the streets. My music is literally the rock and roll of the people, and they're screaming for it, and they're applauding, and I'm making way more money than you are when I'm selling my compositions. So I think I should be paid equally. And that her, the success of this piece, among others, is one of the things that convinced one of the very first pay equity changes in history. This is the last piece she ever wrote, straight from the time of Beethoven, Louise Vermonk.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Well, sorry about the microphone issue here. We want to end with a smooth ending. Artists, please come out again so we can look at you and appreciate you. And yeah, hang around just a little bit. We don't want you to go away too fast. We have to kind of, this is an afterglow. We have to kind of cool down after this hot concert, right? So, Jennifer, did you mostly put together? I suppose you called into your circle what your friends wanted to do, right? And of course, you have those kind of friends who can put together a stunning program, very eclectic, wouldn't you say? Yes, almost 1,000 years of spans, right? Boy, when programs are put together, doesn't it just flow perfectly? And it keeps your attention, doesn't it? So, well, you're a program director for CAP Radio, aren't you, Jennifer? So I guess you know what you're doing, don't you? Anyway, each of you, very special. Just the qualities of sound that you brought to us. And the most interesting use of the piano and of this kind of ancient, mysterious sound that you gave to us. How inventive is that? And I guess they weren't doing that back in 1000 AD, were they? But you're recreating that feeling, or at least the nostalgia that we sense about that age, right? So, Jennifer Reason, of course, thank you for working with me to get this program put together. Ann Moss, what a voice you have. What a fantastic voice. What an instrument that is. You can really paint pictures with that beautifully. And great to have you back, Kathy Apple on the flute. It's been a long time. Were you improvising from the back there?
Yes.
So the live stream showed you back there, even though some of you couldn't see Kathy in the back when she was improvising along with it, and just beautifully. And Timothy Stanley, having you back is also a real treat. So thank you very much for being with us, and we hope you can join us again not too far off in the distance. Okay? Have a wonderful year, and stay safe and stay well. And for you, of course, say safe and say well. And we hope you can join us next week. And next week, we are going to India. Would you like to go with me? Next week to India. Okay. The sound is mysterious and ancient and different. And there will be a question and answers session for next concert. The concert is entitled Classic Sounds of India. So come and see what you think. Hope to see you then. Take care.
I love you. Don't remind me.
Wall Street. And we looked a little bit and played a lot of stuff just on the string. Good to see you. Are you guys going to Summer Sing?
Are they doing it?
Yes.
Oh. Well, usually we're waiting here from Alan, but we didn't sign up.
Oh, well, Alan, he sent out an email with a little video that he is. He sent it to people. I don't know. I got it. I shared it with River City Crowd and my church choir. They are doing it.
Oh my gosh. So
it's
good.
The last weekend in July. And it may not maybe the last one. I don't know. Apparently, it's not very well attended. So
I'll catch you.
Well, it's kind of hard. It's
My church choir came back and literally limping along.
Oh.
And one night we had one alto and one soprano. You can't do music. Our director found a book of anthems for 10 or fewer singers. Basically a two-part anthem. And we're going, it's sad. But the River City Crowd got back and going. We had a great Christmas concert. And then we had a fabulous Pops concert.
Oh,
Summer of Love.
At my chiropractor appointment, I'm like,
Amazon.
Why not?
And,
lovely. That's the piece of it. Cool.
The Irish one?
Yes. I was like, this is getting crazier and crazier and crazier and crazier.
It turns out so tame.
Good. Hope we'll see you there.
What is this?
Hey, Joe.
I actually thought of you. My friend gave me access to his BBC orchestra plugin for, like, it's like, they, you know, like MIDI, but they've recorded the orchestra, and so they have all these cool, like, real flautists playing samples and so on. Like, it's like the best samples I've ever played, but it's all these, like, you can do extended technique, like different tonguing and all this stuff, and I was like, I mean, not that it's replacing real people, but it's getting very close to. Well, the other thing that was really cool, actually, was the cello thing too, but they recorded like the intervals too, so like when you play this thing, it's them actually playing.
Yeah, as opposed to just.
I don't know, when I hear flute, I think. That's like when I hear music. That's awesome. It was a cool, very cool show. The improv stuff.
They were sound checking and I'm like, hey, why don't you do something? How about I do it from back there? I love that.
Yes, okay. I told him, I met last week with Omari, we went to Berkeley Rep to see this musical that was so pretty cool. And I'm actually going again. We closed on Sunday, so I'm going again. It's an 8-person musical. Called Octet. Takes place kind of like a church, but it's like a meeting for people that are addicted to technology, like a support group. And that's the back basis of this church.
Okay.
It was amazing. I made Hannah Kyle go last night. She was like texting me, she's like, oh my god, what just happened?
It
was
fun.
I've never met him.